I am Dr. Muralidhar. Now, let us know a little about DVT, which is very commonly encountered in our practice. DVT means deep vein thrombosis, means it happens normally in the lower limbs. The deep veins are the ones which are present in the middle of the muscles, and they carry blood, collecting blood from the superficial veins and then carry blood to the heart. What happens when there is thrombosis of these deep veins, and when it happens, we should know. There are certain conditions where DVT naturally happens, like, you know, in a case of cancer within the abdomen, DVT happens. There are patients with varicose veins where the DVT is common, and there are certain conditions where the person is made to lie down for a long time after a major accident, or if a person is admitted to ICU when he is not moving, he has been connected with a lot of gadgets like a monitor, catheter, central line. So that patient has a tendency to develop DVT. Or there are certain operations where the operation can go on for 4 hours, 6 hours, there is a chance that the person can get DVT. Or in major orthopedic procedures like knee replacements or hip replacements, the DVT is as high as 80%. Now, you may ask me why we should know about DVT. The DVT causes not only problem in the leg, it can cause problem to the heart and lungs by an entity called pulmonary embolism. What is pulmonary embolism? When a small chunk of blood clot from the DVT gets slipped out and then passes in the blood flow and gets clogged in the pulmonary artery, then it causes pulmonary embolism where the right heart fails and the blood from the right heart cannot enter the lungs, and then of course the oxygenation which was earlier happening in the lungs will not happen and it causes sudden death. So one should be very careful with DVT, because DVT is a precursor for pulmonary embolism, which can end in death. So many times we have observed there are certain major surgeries. 1 week later, following knee replacement, a person dies. It all is because of pulmonary embolism, which actually happened following DVT. So we should know. So what happens in DVT? In DVT, when there is a clot in the deep veins, the entire leg swells. There is a huge swelling of the leg, and this can be found out by the color doppler easily. And how we can treat the DVT is to identify this very early as possible, and then we give injections called anti-coagulants. When these injections are given, the clot which is formed in the veins dissolves and the route is formed for flow of blood. So now initially we give injections, and then later on we give tablets for dissolving this clot. And this has to be given for a few weeks, like 6 weeks or even sometimes 12 weeks. So in which case the complete dissolution of the thrombus happens. And once that happens, the swelling naturally reduces, and then of course the pulmonary embolism, which is, as I told you, can be fatal, will definitely be avoided. So one should be careful with DVT, identification of DVT and treatment of DVT, because when you prevent DVT, you can always prevent death. So be aware of this entity called DVT, which is important, and prevention is always better. So in situations where you anticipate DVT, we preventively give anticoagulant injections, which will avoid DVT.